The parents of Nidgeri mum Jane Thurgood Dove say they want to go to their graves knowing who killed her. They've joined police to launch a new online tool it's hoped will help crack some of Victoria's most baffling cold cases. Maggie Raworth reports.
In 1997, 34-year-old Jane Thurgood Dove was shot in the back of the head in front of her three children.
The brutal murder of a mother of three.
24 years on and the case remains unsolved. Jane's parents, John and Helen McGill, have never had the closure that would have come if their daughter's killer was caught.
It's hard. It's tough. We've toughed it out.
Knowing that that person is still walking the earth when Jane isn't.
Victoria Police today launched a new online platform to help solve murders like Jane's. The Cold Case Homicide Hub is designed to source information from the community.
These are some of the most serious and violent crimes in the state, which cause significant harm to our communities.
Five cases will feature at first, with two new murders added each month. The first five will include the murder of teenagers Fiona Burns and John Lee, who were last seen hitchhiking in 1990, the brutal assault of Samantha Mizzi in St Kilda in 1994, the death of 42-year-old Christopher Phillips at his Cheltenham home in 1989, and the fatal shooting of Christoph Saratavros in a Box Hill car park in the year 2000. And Jane Thurgood Dove. The platform is the first of its kind in Australia and includes background on the investigation, a photograph of the victim, and a personal appeal from the investigator.
And while some of these matters are decades old, it may only take one phone call to solve them.
Right now, there are more than 200 unsolved deaths sitting within the Homicide Squad's files. Some cases date back as far as 1951.
As for Jane Thurgood Dove, police are confident someone somewhere knows something that could help solve the case, and to that someone...
I would say please, as a mother of a murdered daughter, so that we can go to our graves knowing.
Maggie Raworth, Nine News.